Second-ranked South Dakota State will play its Missouri Valley Football Conference home opener tomorrow as the second-ranked team in the FCS hosts the Fighting Leathernecks of Western Illinois. Hi, friends. Tyler Merriam, and welcome to Game Day E. Before we get started, if you're a podcaster, subscribe to the Jackrabbit Sports Network. Hours of hourly content, replays of game broadcasts, coaches' interviews, and much, much more. Subscribe to the Jackrabbit Sports Network wherever you podcast. Number two, SDSU at sixth-ranked Missouri State last Saturday. What a performance by the Jackrabbits, particularly on defense in the show-me state. SDSU with four sacks, holding the Bears to 15 points fewer than their season average and 150 yards below their season production. Of course, one of the biggest plays of the day by the sophomore safety from Katy, Texas, Colby Herter, who intercepts a pass in the red zone from the talented quarterback Jason Shelley and runs it back 70 yards to tilt the scales. What a huge play that was in the football game. The Jacks on offense, no slouches in their own right. Mark Gronowski, 22 of 29, a career high, 319 yards, and also a career best with four touchdown passes, and he hit Zach Hines often. The only time he threw a pass to Hines that was an incompletion, he threw the ball 20 yards over his head out of bounds. Hines' career highs of seven receptions and 127 yards for the Sioux Falls, Washington alum. Meanwhile, Jaden Yockey had a career high eight receptions for 102 yards, including that beautiful catch on SDSU's opening score. The Jackrabbits coming off that big victory now are home back-to-back weekends, and it will start with Western Illinois, the Leathernecks, who are in search of their first win of the season. They are in a transition as far as the program is concerned, led by rookie head coach Myers Hendrickson. He was all Missouri Valley Football Conference as a punt returner for the Leathernecks a little more than a decade ago. First year as head coach, he spent four seasons leading Kansas Wesleyan. All he did there was win 30 and lose only once. He does have some local ties too. He spent two seasons as the offensive coordinator up in Aberdeen at Northern State University. Western has not led in a game this year. Again, the Leathernecks have never led in their first four games. They only have 16 total points scored in the first halves of four games this season. And a lot of the issues have been them trying to find a quarterback. They played four games. They've had three different starting quarterbacks, and they're all healthy. They're just trying to find the right guy. Number five, Clay Bruno, has been their most recent starter, a 5'10 junior out of Rochester, Illinois. He's rushed for 110 yards. He's the only individual on the Leatherneck team with over 100 rushing yards after four complete games. Last week against Northern Iowa, in his first start of his college career, 166 yards and a score, but he was also picked three times. Running back number 34, Ludovic Choquette, is an exceptional talent, was very good a year ago, injured earlier this year. Don't know if we'll see him on Saturday. He's a young man who had multiple FBS offers. If we don't see him, number 20, Aaron Collins, likely to get the majority of the handoffs. He's in his fourth different school, 6'2", 212. He's a sixth-year senior, but he has struggled to build up the running game, only 2.3 yards a carry. But this is a Leatherneck team that'll use a lot of different individuals at running back, a lot at wideout, but the name you're going to want to keep an eye out for is Nassim Brantley. He wears number 18. He is an all-conference caliber wide receiver, probably the best overall athlete on the Leathernecks, particularly on offense. Brantley is third in the nation in receiving touchdowns. He's caught five of those. He's eighth in the nation in receiving yards. His 21 catches have covered 388 yards. Long frame, goes up and gets the football. Brantley is one of the most talented wideouts in all of the Missouri Valley Football Conference. But the Leathernecks offensively as a team, the numbers indicate how much they've struggled, only converting one out of every five third downs, just 20% for a conversion rate, and they have turned the football over 11 times in just four games. We turn to the defense. The numbers aren't pretty there, allowing 43 points and 517 yards a game. A little perspective on that, the SDSU defense this season is allowing 252 yards a game. The Leathernecks are allowing 296 per game through the air alone. So again, Western was something to work on there. A few names to keep an eye out for. One is number one, J.J. Ross, the cornerback out of Cincinnati. He leads the Missouri Valley in pass breakups with 5. He's intercepted 2 balls. He's made 19 stops on the year. The leading tackler is a 6'3 sophomore, plays what they call the flex position, so sometimes he'll be at the line of scrimmage, other times back at a traditional linebacker spot. Number 51, Chase Graham, team high 34 tackles. He's a transfer, was a Division III All-American a year ago. As far as the special teams game goes for Western Illinois, the kicker is Mason Laramie, number 45, 13 for 20 as far as field goals go in his career, but he has had 4 blocked, his career long, a 53-yarder 2 years back at Illinois State. Number 9, Jafar Armstrong, 13, Jay Parker are both threats in the return game, and that's the story on Western Illinois as the Leathernecks come to town tomorrow afternoon for the Precision Ag Bowl on Hall of Fame weekend. Kickoff at 2 o'clock, Midco Sports, ESPN+, Jackrabbits All Access, the way you can watch it. Our radio coverage with Alex Parker, Scotty Quaz, Brent Bowen, and myself begins at noon throughout the Jackrabbits Sports Network, GoJacks.com, the Jackrabbit app, the Varsity Network app, or if you're coming into Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium tomorrow, you can listen throughout the stadium on 98.1 FM. 2 o'clock is the kickoff as second-ranked South Dakota State hosts Western Illinois. It's the Precision Ag Bowl and Hall of Fame weekend here at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium.